Hello and welcome. I'm Gerard, and this is Transport Fever 2 with part 1 of the How Big Can We Grow experiment. That's right, we will be conducting a series of experiments in the next few weeks on different sized maps with increasing number of cities. So click the subscribe button and follow this journey with me. Today we are starting with a tiny map in 1x1 ratio with 2 towns. So let me show you how to set it up. We are here in the map editor. The only things that you have to do around here is choose the map size, the map format. You don't even have to click on the seat at the moment, and the rest also don't matter at the moment, and then you click start. Okay, here we are. Now, I have a seat for you. I will post it in the description of the video if you want, but basically it's this one. So the only thing you have to do is here, you will put the hilliness to 0, waters to 0, forest is up to you. I put it on the max. You paste the seed, you generate. It's going to generate the map that you're going to see in a little bit. There it is. Now, you don't post any towns, you don't put any industries, you don't click anything else. The only thing you can do is save the map here in a file, or save and play, whatever you choose. And that's it for the map. Now we are back to the menu. Then we go to free game, play map, we choose the map that we just created, and for the options, of course, you will find a list of the mods in the description of the video. For the rest here, we are going to have climate, temperature, vehicles, all town names, whatever you choose, environment, again, I guess, whatever you choose, the difficulty is easy, it doesn't really matter. Also, none of this matters. Here, we're going to put this to the, these three to the max, because I want the towns to grow to the maximum possible, what the game allows, of course. And we also don't want any of the negative effects, so those three here are to the zero. You click apply and then you start. And I will see you there. Alright, here we are in our very, very flat map, as you can see. One of the reasons why I chose this seat, of course, is that it's very flat, doesn't have any hills and water, as we already did in the start of the video. And we are going to continue now with the town builder. It's the game-changing, life-saving mod that I wish I found earlier in my life. So the town builder allows you to plop towns on your own choosing with a lot of configuration. Just look at that. So first we can see our map here, and we have to choose a location for our first town. And I'm going to choose this little square here. Now you have plenty of things to configure on the town builder. First is the position, but we already chose that, so we're not going to touch it. The town name, I definitely don't care in general, but Roseville sounds stupid to me, so let's call this Trigrad, for example. Town size. Town size is going to be the number 200. Why? Well, because if you go to the map editor, or as me right now, you have the sandbox mode on, and you choose a huge city to plop somewhere on the map, it's going to be of size 200. So that's why we're choosing 200, because that is the biggest town that we can plop without cheating. All right, for town cargo, we are going to have everything. For the street layout, I'm pretty sure I will use all of them in the future with the rest of the playthroughs, but for today, I'm going to choose this one. And the street network size is how big your town is, basically, as you can see. I didn't know actually that this zooms out and in, but apparently it does. And we're going to choose 6, because I found this to be pretty good size for these towns and for this experiment for today. The major road interval, let's reset so that we see this better. There you go. The major road interval is how often you're going to have major roads. Every this number is going to be a major road. So if you put 1, every road is a major road. If you put 2, every second road is a major road. And we are going to put 4, because I think it looks really, really nice. And for you to see it even better, I'm going to click it like that. So these are the major roads, and the rest are non-major roads. But not all of the rest are apparently minor roads. Why? Well, now we're going to choose our minor street type, and I'm going to choose the large street with 4 lanes and 60 kilometers per hour. And as you can see, we still have some very tiny streets. So there is 3 types, and you can only choose 2 of them, which I don't understand why, but it is what it is. For our magistrate type, we are going to choose the extra large street, 6-lane street with speed limit of 60 kilometers. And now that we have chosen this, we continue with the rest. Build highways. Oh yes, but we are going to do this last after we build urban highways. I don't think so, because this just adds unnecessary roads and I don't think I really need them. So we're not going to do that. Open street network only removes the last layer of streets here. I don't want to allow tunnels and bridges. Our town is not in an elevated area or anything like that, so I think it should be placed without a problem. And roundabouts adds roundabouts on all the major road intersections, which I definitely want to have. Local streets basically gives you player ownership of all the streets, and the AI cannot change them, move them, do anything, anything that they want with it. Okay, bus lanes on major roads. No, I don't think so. Tram tracks on major roads, yes. So now all the major roads are going to have tram tracks and we are going to save ourselves a lot of clicking. Add bus stops, sure. Add bus lines, sure. And circular, sure. So we can click this one, but nothing happens unless we click those, which is to add the bus stops and the bus lines. I think if I don't click the bus lines, I also don't get the circular. But I might be wrong, to be honest. But let's add everything. It's very easy to delete them, much harder to put them. But this is going to save us a lot of time as well. And now we're going to do the highways. So first, if I click this, you will see that a bunch of things appear around the city, which is great. Like, seriously, this is amazing. And not only that, it's even better because you can change everything to your liking. So we are in the top right corner, which means that this here is going to be our connection. So we're going to change it to a diagonal connection like that. And these things on the left and bottom, or in other words, south and west, are going to be roundabout interchanges. Not this one though. This is going to be a two-way connecting curve. This is going to be a trumpet, two-way. And this one is going to be a roundabout as well. And when we do this, we have closed all the connections on this side, but we still have these connections open here. And I think that's going to come in handy. Actually, I don't think I even need those, because I think we are going to add this down, then another one on the opposite side. Here we're going to have like the base production, and here we're going to have end production. And I don't think I need the base production from here. So yeah, I think I'm also going to close these ones. So that is a trumpet as well. And we're only going to have these open. Okay. And now we build the town. And hopefully everything is going to go without incident. Oh, we can actually expand the town after that. Oh, nice, nice. I didn't know. Okay, there we go. There is our town with all our interchanges. Let's see if all the connections are proper, because sometimes mistakes happen. Yeah, everything seems extremely, extremely reasonable. Look at that beautiful, beautiful roundabout. Okay, perfect. That's our first city, which is called Murieta now, for some reason. I think I can change that without a problem. And we are going to place another one without so many explanations, because you already know what we are going to do. The only thing we're going to change here is this becomes the way. This is going to be the diagonal. And this is going to be a roundabout. Yes. So we have closed, closed, closed. This one has to be closed as well. On this side, trumpet. Yes. Perfect. And we can build. And there you go. We have our second town. Perfect. All right. Now, we have to connect our two beautiful towns. Huntington Beach. Oh my goodness. Can we get something else? Okay. This is going to be Trigrad. And this is going to be Vizima. There you go. Now, street construction. We want an interchange. Stuck interchange. This one is not bad at all. But we are already very high here, unfortunately. You know what we can do? We can probably make our life a little bit easier like this. And also on this side. Okay. So they are fairly high. Maybe I have to make the interchange high as well. So I guess my two options actually are the cloverleaf and the stack interchange, yeah. Actually, this one is not bad as well. Not at all, actually. I think this one might work even better. Because I don't even need that many good connections to that middle road, because it's going to be used primarily for industry, right? And we just want to connect these two. Yeah. I think that's perfect. Okay, overall size. Let's make it big. Number of junctions. Oh, no. Only one is enough. Thank you very much. Roundabout. Let's make it bigger. Yeah, that looks even better. Too much slope. Why? Too much slope where? Ah, on these things on the side, I think it's the problem. Gap between junctions. No idea if this changes anything. Lane count. We can put 1, 2. Lane count, 2. Sure, I think we can go with 3 as well. I mean, highway height. Yeah, I don't think that's what we need. Can you? Yes, you can. So I think I need to increase it a little bit, elevate it. Traffic site, central tight. Do I have it tight? No, I don't think I want to have it tight. Let's make it normal. It's better, yeah. And maybe, what about this? Does this do anything at all? I don't think so. Overall size. Yeah, I think I want the biggest one. Okay, I think that's it. Now we just have to find its place somewhere in the middle. And I think I also want to maybe increase it a little bit in height, something like that. Yes. This kind of looks... Alright, come on, move in the middle. Yes, okay. So it's going to be that height. And a little bit like that. I think too much slope. I have no idea why this is continuing saying that. Boom. It's probably because of this. This looks ugly. I don't know why it appears like that. This is a two-way road, right? Let's see. No, it's this one. That's better. Oops. The problem is that if I delete this part, we totally lose it. Okay, it doesn't matter, let's stick it again. Something like that. Oh yeah, that looks so much better. Good stuff. But I think this has to be opposite. Okay, and this is so ugly as well, so let's delete that as well. Oh, why is this has to be straight? Okay, it's not the best, but this is what we can do, I guess. Oh, no, something like that is better, yeah. Okay, this is the proper direction. Cool. And this is the last. I don't know why I have to fix those. But that's how the mod came, so we have to take care of it. Okay? It's not perfect, but it is what it is. Alright. This is great, because now we can build our final production here in our first stage of production over there. Okay, so Ah, but of course, first, let's connect here. This is 3, so we need 3. Yes. That's all right. Hey, come on, game. You can do it. You can cooperate. Thank you very much. That's pretty good, I guess. And your sight. Okay. And we are okay here as well. On top of everything, I think I can even put rods here if I need to for anything. I don't think so, but we have the option. All right. Now, we need to extend this, not one way, but country road. With this, if I'm not mistaken, let's go to the ground. How quickly can we get to the ground? This seems reasonable. Okay, and let's do the same on the other side. I should have measured it. How long is it? It's like 264. 66. Okay, perfect. I don't know if I need 3, to be honest, but a 3-lane road, but that's fine, I guess. Doesn't bother me. And now we are going to extend it. Ooh, why do you do this? Clicking the M button to raise it to the ground level 500. Okay. Something like that it should be. And we will do the same. Ooh. On the other side. These guidelines from the new update are great to see. 2 million. Yeah. 2 million, 1.2, 1.1. Somewhere around there. Boom. Yeah, and we have a pretty long road here. Alright, now there is a few more things we have to do. We have to come here and click on custom cargo in both our towns. Alright, that's great. And now we have to choose what we are going to have in our towns. Now, I am thinking, let's see. Let's see, so Vizima is going to have cargo, let's see, tools, food and goods. I think we can put goods here, tools and food, and then tools, goods, food, and then the other guy is going to have food, goods, tools. Food, goods, tools. There you go. Perfect. Perfection. Now, for the construction material, what are we going to do? Construction material, fuel, machines. Let's have machines there and let's just switch these two. Construction, so it's fuel, machines, construction material. Fuel, machines, construction material. Great. Great stuff. I like it very much like that. Okay, they're going to start growing immediately. Ah, by the way, let me show you also. So we have some lines here. As you can see, we have a line like that, a line like this, and a circular, two circular lines, if I'm not mistaken. Yeah, one going this way and one going that way. Ah, also, something else I have to do because the game buys, not the game, but I guess the mod buys this weird tram. I don't know why. Yeah, we can only see it here. Ooh, by the way, I also don't want this. Can I delete it? Yeah, actually I can. And they're all plopped here. I think so, yeah. So we have this weird tram. Absolutely not. We are a modern town here. So let's do capacity and also only passengers. This one looks very nice, but I think it's too big. 130, 150, 136. So let's start maybe with this one. Yeah, with 27 capacity. Looks pretty cool. There we go. And then we shall see. We shall see what happens with time. Let's also see our districts. Ooh, our industry is in this side. That's fine. So these guys definitely should not do that. Cool. And here. Yeah, I guess everything is fine. Awesome. Awesome. I guess now we can just play the game and see. Oh my god, we already have plus 50, plus 70. We are growing. Awesome. Awesome stuff to see. Now, let's see what we are going to do. So we have food here. And we have tools. These are super easy to produce, which is awesome. I think we will start with tools. And we are going to build ourselves a little forest at the edge of town. So here is our connections. So this is our base resource area here. It's interesting, I guess I didn't put it in the center because this is going here and not in the middle, but that's all right. Little mistakes are allowed. Now, how much are we going to need? These towns are going to grow hopefully 10 times as much. I think we will need at least two tools factories, so that makes four forests. Let's build four forests then, and not forget to increase this production level and turn the auto upgrade. How are we going to build our forests? Let's do... We can face this way, I guess. I don't really care. Would be like that, and then another one. Another one like here, and... Maybe this one, let's do a continuation of this road and then go from there. This forest could potentially be here. And this one, maybe something like that. Now we delete these roads that we definitely do not need. And we have four forests here, and hopefully we can build our first station right next to them. Yeah. Oh, this one doesn't have connections, right? Yeah, so let's have a road which connects to everything. We can actually make it like this, and a little bit of a turn here, and like that. Boom. Make it more reasonable. Okay. Can we put a few... Where is my assets? Garden. No. Where? Tree. Tree? What type of trees are those? Is it this type of tree? No. This? Definitely not. Something higher? Oh yeah. This looks better. So let's add a few more. Burst size and strength is probably the problem. There we go. Now it looks more like a forest. Perfect. I love it. Okay. Good stuff. Now we need... What do we need? We need a cargo station, truck station. That's a lot of forests. I think at least three platforms on this side. So something like here probably makes sense. Also, I don't need them to be that long because I'm going to destroy them right away. Yeah, that works for me. Yep. Boom. Now we can just connect here and check. Yep, we have everyone on site. Good stuff. We are going to delete this now. And since this is a forest, we are going to put one of those and one of those, and then another one of the train truck cargo platform. And it looks awesome because these are going to be locks. And locks are transported by cranes, of course. Now, we need some storage area here because we're going to have plenty. That would be awesome if I could have put it, but I cannot. put some here, and let's see what's going to be allowed on this side, like that. Okay, I think that's pretty good. We're going to call this Forests Cargo Truck. Okay. Forests Truck. Cargo is kind of obvious, no? Forests Truck. Okay. Awesome. Now we just have to connect to our vault in a reasonable manner. I think what we can do, because I really... Let's just extend it so that we... There we go. Here. Boom. And then we can just connect whatever we want. With which one? Probably this one is fine. I mean, they're going to have to... Yeah, just make a turn. I don't think it matters. Ooh, we can also do that, I guess. I don't think it really matters. Because they're going to be slow anyway in the beginning. And then they can speed up. Oh, you know what? I just figured out. Like, this is going to be... So I'm going to take the logs from here, deliver them to the planks factory, and then deliver the planks to the... tools factory. Which means... Ooh, we already have people using our highways here. Awesome stuff to see. Oh, and this is your traffic changes from the last update. Look at that. Switching lanes and everything. This guy was not sure where to go, I guess. All right. Oh, we even have people coming from here. So cool. Oh, and they're using this to travel around the city. Where are you going, buddy? Let's see. So, destination, residential building. Okay. Where did you come from? Where is the guy? That guy, right? Destination. So, you came from... So, you came from the commercial building in Trigrad. Your work is here by car. Interesting. You know what? I will have to actually set up some kind of a public transportation between the two cities. I think that would be very important. But everything with its time, right? Not right now. Right now, we want to supply some locks. Okay, so I think we can make this a tram station. Because we want to use those as well, right? Why not? That doesn't change what I just did, by the way. We can still have this connection, I think. Like this. That's completely fine. But what is not fine is the size of my station. So how big are those? I think they're like seven sections big, if I'm not mistaken, from before. So that means that's 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Yeah, I think that's how it's going to be. And this is going to be very nice to see, actually, on the road. Some trams. I don't see why not. Absolutely works for me. We can put more storage, I guess. Let's put configure and cargo. Let's add a few more. Boom. I'm pretty sure I can add... Ooh. No, still no. Okay. I think we can connect this one here now. That. And like this. Sure. However, we definitely need to upgrade everything with tram trucks. There we go. Now we have the tram trucks. Boom, boom, boom. Oh, I just... Yeah, this one doesn't have a straight connection. It has to be in the roundabout. That's all right. Let's have it here. Let's have it here and to the end there. Perfect. So now we can have our trams here. That means... Do I want to add a bus lane as well? I don't think so. I don't expect to have any other traffic here. And the new traffic update should allow trucks to take over each other. So that's perfect. Okay. We have the forest. Let's add on the other side of the map some Somios. How are these Somios going to work? Let's see. One here. Ooh, maximum level, of course. Don't forget that. And another one on the other side. Boom. Delete this. And now, station here. Facing this way, I think so. Why not? Let's see what we can do. Three on this side. We can do snapping. Snapping very much. I can also put it like that. I will need, however, some storage here. I will have space, I think. So let's put it like this. And then we can come to the streets. And connect this like that. We have to delete all of this, as you know. 1, 2, 3. And then 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. 3. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. And one more. And that's it. Okay, and storage. Yeah, of course that doesn't work. Let's see what else we can get here. Oh, come on. No. Oh, it's because... No, me digas. That's impossible. Okay, do you know what we're going to do? We're going to delete this. We're going to add our storage here. The way that we want. As much as we want. I'm pretty sure something like that is fine. And then I'm going to add this back here. It might complain, but that's its problem, not mine. Okay, I don't know this one, right? Yes. Okay. Connection. So, Muse. It's not even truck, so I'm not going to even add that. It's for trams. Okay, and the last thing we need here is this connection with electric trams. Cool. That works, right? I mean, I'm not making any mistakes here. I don't think so. Okay. Now, so they're going to come through here and they're going to be moving this way. Do we want to cross? I don't think so. We can just add on this side the tools factory, although it has to go there, and then we can connect to this road and then just go this way. Mm-hmm. I like that idea. That's why I left this open, so that we can connect there. Okay, so let's add our first connections. What are you doing on the road, you? You didn't see... I did see you. You didn't see anything, dear. That's how people die, man. Okay. It's looking good, right? Yeah, it's looking good. Okay, so somewhere around here, after we... go down from the highway, we're going to open ourselves these. I think that's fine. And we have to add two tools factories here. And I want to... what do I want to do? I will add them. So I want to deliver here. So I'm going to have a station here with a right side delivery, and then on the other side I'm going to pick them up, connect over there, and deliver it wherever it's needed. Sounds good to me. I'm also thinking about something else. Maybe I want to have like lines that deliver somewhere inside. Maybe like have a big delivery station somewhere around here, and then take it and bring it to the city from here. Does that make sense? I think so. Because otherwise I have to deliver... that's a very interesting question. Directly from the source. So if I have my factories here and I deliver directly to the source, That's also all right, I guess. But the trucks are going to... But I can use bigger trucks if I deliver from here to there and then have lower emission trucks inside of the city. And it's going to make more sense because that's how it works in the real life. Yeah, let's do it like that. It's going to be probably a little bit more work, but I think it's a little bit better. So. Those. Maximum level. And how do we put you like that? Yeah, it makes sense. Why not? And we do... Well, actually, it's not that nice. Yes. And... Can you... Turn? And this one goes... Here. And I don't think I need both. I do need this, however. Yes. Okay, so... I will rebuild that street. Something like this. No. And now we can add our station. Cargo. Wait, no. Buildings. Here. Perfect. That's it. That's perfection. And I don't need that connection, but I will delete it. After, so we don't need this. We also don't need those guys. We can just add them after. One here, one here, one here, one here. And okay, we can add it here as well. I don't care. And I guess we can delete that now and add it again. This one needs to have electric though. Perfect. This one doesn't because it's not updated. Okay. That's good. Looking good, right? I think so. I need to add, I guess, starting from here. Yeah. Okay. Oh, but this one now it looks ugly. Huh? That's why. Yeah. So I don't want this. I want this. It doesn't look ugly, but it doesn't look the same, which is going to bother me. Okay. And now we have it, because this is going to deliver tools here. Wait, but... Oh my god. No, it's not going to deliver tools. Oh my god, it's going to deliver planks, of course. The tools we're going to pick up from there. From the other side. Okay. That's perfect. That's tools delivery. No, tools delivery. Again, planks delivery. Planks delivery. Because that's what we're doing here. Okay, and then we're going to pick up the tools from the other side. So, we need... that's interesting. Okay, we definitely need a cargo station, but how the cargo station... Ah, it directly has the electrical wiring, I see. Okay. No, this one doesn't have to have it. And let's put it like that. Here we will have to need, we will need storage as well. And since this is going to be tools, I think the covered platform is perfect. And I'm going to add, I'm going to add 3 for now, but I'm pretty sure we might need more, but let's start with 3. And I'm going to add storage only on the front and the back, not on the sides, because we might expand it in the future. And this is going to be tools pickup. Pick up. All right. Looking good. Looking good. And now we can connect this over there. And then the trucks can find their... Their own... Whatever. Road. Path. Let's first exit. No, actually, they're going to be coming kind of fast, maybe. So so we can even give them a bigger road. And from here, just connect. That's not very pretty. I could have different connections from here, I guess. Also, I don't know if I need three-way. But why not? Maybe we can we keep 100 kilometers per hour and get there somehow? There, 100. 60. I can, yeah, if I have, as I said, the connections separately. Something like that. I don't think it's a big deal. Yeah, that works very well for me. Okay, perfect. Let's do, so this is two, so this is maybe the first station that we have to add. Where are we going to add it though? Here, let's see, what is the biggest station that we can build with 10 on each side? Can it fit here? Ooh, it actually can. That's so cool. Okay. Interesting. Very interesting. I will need some storage space though, so... Do we have one exit and one entrance? That's maybe okay. But I'm not quite sure. If I put it here, maybe I can connect it to that other road on the other side as well. Somehow. What if we put it here? Can I put it like that? Ooh, I can actually do that. Yeah. Does that make more sense? Maybe. But what if I want to make it a little bit longer, right? Like 20 meters. Now that does not fit. Well, it doesn't have to be 10 by 10, right? Although if I'm going to use the same station to deliver things and then pick them up for the city. Now that's a good question. But technically for pickup I need more maybe. And if I put it here, maybe it has to be two stations. One for delivery and one for pickup. Most of the delivery is on this side, so it's definitely going to be here. Let's see. I can add maybe the stations here. Platforms here like that. Maybe I can add it here. Yeah. No. But it has to be like that so that it can grow, actually. Yeah, I think so. I think that makes more sense. And if I make it 30 meters, are we good? I think so. I think we can make it. Can I connect here? I actually can, but it's going to become ugly, right? Yeah. I could, however, have a connection maybe to the roundabout. We shall see. Okay, I will add this here and just try to see if that's going to work. Yes, it works. Nice. And this one works here as well, which is perfect. So we have an entrance and an exit. So this is going to be the delivery one and we're going to have a pickup one as well. Maybe somewhere around here. They're going to have enough connection for sure, yeah. Would be nice if I can make it like this. Okay, actually I can, why not? I can put it here. With that, can you not? No, okay, so this is my... Actually, this one doesn't have to be that big because it's the echo trucks. Okay, and here we can add... Actually, this is a city street, so... No, but that means slow. can do this. Okay, we don't have any lights anywhere. That's pretty cool. Okay, so... I'm going to start by delivering tools here. Which means... I don't know what type of station to create, to be honest. Well, we are going to start with those, so let's give it this. Alright. I can actually add a few other exits around here, maybe? Why not? Maybe this one is going to be used by something. Who knows? Is that a light? Oh my god. No, I have to click it every time. Please, no lights. No one likes lights, man. I can do the same here. But they're going to be entering from here and they can exit from there. Something like that. Or they can exit the same way. I don't think it matters. Yeah, I don't think it matters. For now, we shall see. So this is going to be Vizima drop off. Drop off? No, drop start. Vizima pickup. Vizima pickup? Yeah. And this is going to be Vizima delivery. Delivery. Okay. That's good. That's pretty good. Okay, so. Let's start. Road vehicles. I think we can start by starting one here. Oh, by the way, one other thing. Oh, why is the game paused? I don't even know why and when I paused it. Is there a depot here? No, I deleted it, right? Yeah. I think. Sure. So, we can add depots. Building. One here. Another one there. And this, of course, has to be... Ta-ram. Like that. Cool stuff. I'm curious why... I probably should upgrade those right now. Yep. I should upgrade all the streets to a double. This one. Even the tiny ones. Especially the ones in the center, man. Because all of this is going to be an enormous amount of traffic very, very soon. Believe that. Small. No lights, right? I don't think so. And here. Everything. These cities are going to grow, believe me. Yeah, you see, that's why. See what happens with the traffic. Okay, the large roads are just the large roads, and I don't see anything small here. And we unfortunately... Oh, hello there. Yeah, now we will have to move that building that just got... Ah, it just got moved. Okay. Okay, so we did everything on this line. Not that, and that. This, that. Boom. Sorry, this is going to take us some time, but it's totally necessary to do as early as possible, or we are going to suffer the consequences. Okay, that looks awesome. Now, we can concentrate on adding some trucks. Wait, let's add the lines first. So take from here, drop off here, and then come here. Okay, so first, this is going to be called cargo rail delivery. No, cargo rail supply. And this is logs, planks. Logs, planks? Yes, logs, planks. Let's call it like that. And whatever color, it doesn't really matter. Now, forest truck. Please take number 3 and then anything else. Sawmills. Again, number 3 and then anything else. And planks delivery is number 3 and then anything else. Okay, in forest. Full load any. And you will only load logs. In the sawmills, you will unload the logs and pick up the planks. Okay. And here you are just going to unload the planks. Cool stuff. Nice. Now, we are going to add ourselves depots. If we can. Yeah, that's a good depot. I don't think I need anything else for now. Now we need locks. And we need the fast one. Hey, I just need something that can carry locks, man. What? Why I just have me? Ah, there. 10. 10? Wait. What the hell is happening? Where is... Wow. There's something wrong with my... mod or what? Where is my smaller ones? Smaller versions? Ah, there is 8. And something weird happened, I guess. Ah, there you go. 2x, 6x, 8. Okay, so this is the one that we want. What happened? I cannot add it because something is not electrified or what? Catenary, yes. Here. Yeah. Locks planks now can be a tram. Okay, and here we need... It's going to be 1600, but I don't think we need that. Ooh, oh my god, look at this. 44? Oh my god, that's going to be... Okay, we have to copy. Let's start with 10. And then we shall see. 400 is plenty. That's fucking insane. How many trams am I going to need here? Absolute craziness, man. I think I should double that so that we can... Like, if I have a rate of 400, that means I can only produce 200 tools. And I think I am very soon going to be there. So let's increase that amount. Let's keep it at 20. And the calculations are going to be easy anyway. And there we go. And our first... Our chain of trams is already moving. Oh, working flawlessly. I love it. I love these trams. Look at how beautiful it is. I could have pushed it a little bit forward, maybe. Nah. It is what it is. It's going to be like that. Okay, so the first locks are already moving. That means we're going to start producing... tools very, very soon, so we need to bring them to Vizima. Now, let's say the tools pick up and we're going to create a line from here to that one. We are going to call this cargo rail delivery. Cargo rail? No. Cargo truck delivery. Why rail? What the hell? And it's going to be Vizima tools. Vizima tools. Okay, pretty good. So here, let's go there. And yeah, whatever, choose the last one always and take those. Load if available? No, full load. And please load tools. And in Vizima, you are going to unload the tools. And you're going to choose this one. And that's it. And this one is going to be magically transferred there. We need to buy some vehicles though for this. Again, let's see. If I put it here, it's going to be a light, right? Yeah. So it has to be inside. Without a road connection. Can it be outside? Yeah, why not? Put it here. This one. And that one there. And I'm probably going to regret this because, yeah, I'm going to have my deliveries here. Oh, it's not easy. Okay, that's better. Maybe here it's going to work better. I want this rod to connect like that. Perfect. And now we want to buy something that can carry tools by capacity. Largest capacity, the tarpaulin truck 32. Oh, we have these beautiful trucks here. Let's choose the DHL. Huh. Okay. No. But do I want to? How expensive are they? They're a little bit cheaper. Wow, that's 1 million. Why not, man? Let's assign it to the Vizima tools. And we need... How much do we need, Vizima? I will put it at 300. I think that's a good starting point. 51, so that's 6 trucks. There, 300. And the only thing we are needing here is to deliver it to Vizima. I think I can go for the moment with one truck station. And it can be a short one like this one. Because I'm pretty sure I cover pretty much everything here. Absolutely. So this is going to be Vizima commercial drop 1. Okay, and we have from here to here, the naming would be cargo truck delivery. Cargo truck, okay, that would be a drop. Cargo drop, there, very nice. Because it's always a truck or tram. Cargo drop and Vizima commercial drop 1. Commercial drop 2? No, 1. Vizima commercial drop 1. Okay. Or why do I even need that, to be honest? Vizima commercial drop 1. There you go. And, yeah, always that and these. And here it's load. Load whatever is commercial and unload the commercial things in the commercial zone. Awesome. And we will need to add some depots here as well, I guess. Nope, don't snap at me. And connect them. Oh, come on. Okay, come on. Yes. Like that. And we are going to get some urban e-trucks and put them in Vizima commercial drop. First of all, of course, the color has to be blue. 60, so it's pretty much the same. No, it's not the same. It's 5 trucks. 5 trucks. Perfect. So are we producing already? Shipment, yes. Yes, there you go. Shipment, 45, 47. Increasing, baby. Yeah, this is absolutely overloading, and that doesn't surprise anyone, right? Because these are producing on the maximum, and I absolutely don't have that capacity. But that's all right, because we already have our first setups here, and I love it. There is our urban trucks. Woohoo! Going empty. Delivering tools, but that's going to happen soon when we get them delivered first to the city. Ah, there you go. Maybe we have some. Yeah, we have some tools. You see? Everything is working without a problem. Perfect. I love this system. I love it. All right. 761. We have some growth to get to. Sure. Awesome. Here comes the end of today's episode. How do you like the experiment so far? Let me know in the comment section below, but not before you drop the video a like and subscribe if you haven't already. Thank you for watching, and see you in the next one.